after the Easter long weekend, you might already be planning a holiday for later in the year. So where can you go and what can you do for the best budget travel? Let's welcome TID travel specialist Phil Sylvester.
Yay!
Phil, so let's talk about some budget places that we can take the family.
Sure. Look, if you're going to head to Southeast Asia, Thailand, Bali usually on the list. Mm-hmm. Cambodia is a great one. Mm. Cheap as chips. Mm. Really, yeah. Really very cheap.
Once you get over there with the airfare.
And, of course, there's plenty of cheap airfares up to Southeast Asia. You get the magnificent Angkor Wat in Cambodia as well, which you can go and visit. If you're looking for the, you know, cocktail, umbrella, jet ski holiday, it's not quite the destination, but you will have an amazing experience. Other destinations, India is still cheap as well. But if you want to go European flavour, try Bulgaria and the capital, Sofia. All right. Beautiful. Well, and Spartacus was from Bulgaria as well, back in Roman times. But really, really beautiful ancient culture. Sick of paying $7 for a beer? Yeah, try about $1.75 in Bulgaria.
Wow.
All right, and everything else is like comparable with that as well.
And Phil, have you got some best deals for cruising?
Cruising, incredibly popular out of the capital cities of Australia. If you buy more than a year ahead, you can get a pretty good deal. But if you also wait till the very last minute, just about as they're ready to weigh anchor, you can get a really, because they want to fill it up. Yeah. And there are some of the, here we go, here's some sites that you can shoot. Cruise Guru, Cruise Sail Finder, and Cruise Sheet. They have all got like last minute.
And what are you talking in terms of price? If it was a local cruise,
you'll probably save like 30%.
Wow. Okay.
Really? On some of them.
And is everything included on a cruise, like food, drinks?
Some of them are. Make sure you check that when you.
How last minute are we talking? We're like, oh, it leaves in 5 minutes. Grab your bags, or the day before.
I mean, it gets cheaper the closer they get to sailing date, but from 30 days out, basically.
Oh, can they let you know if you put your details in? Will they then let you know when the last minute deals are coming?
Yeah. And just go on and.
And Phil, I am a massive train nerd. I love train travel. How does it stack up in Europe and the UK?
Look, budget airlines are not always the cheapest airlines, and train travel can be your good alternative. By the time you've added up all the added extras for your luggage and choosing your seat and what have you, great thing about train travel is you can, like, you start in the capital, middle of the capital city, and you end up in the middle of the next city that you're going to. If you want, you can catch those very high-speed trains, and they're about comparable to a budget airline. But if you're prepared to, you know, pick the next slowest one, get the express instead of the very fast train, you can save a heap. And you get to see more of the view as you go past. Yep.
So what do you recommend for mobile phone connections, you know, when we're out of Australia?
Forget global roaming. Switch it off. Don't worry about it. All of that stuff.
You get a really massive bill, right?
Yeah, and even if you, you know, organise global roaming with your company, with your provider before you go, Wi-Fi's everywhere these days.
Right.
And, you know, get those messaging apps like WhatsApp and what have you. Forget sending SMSs. Yeah. Forget making calls. Jump on those, or, you know,
make calls
Facebook
online, like Viber,
Facebook
and stuff
Live,
as well.
Viber, Facebook Live.
Yeah. Something that I've come across lately, which I didn't know was even a thing out there, is people travelling overseas, and elderly couples. This works for really well, and finding someone who's got a house they want to be sat, and maybe that you have somebody that can come to your house as well. I didn't know this was a thing.
Yeah, house swapping.
New wife swapping, but I didn't know.
See if you can make a special arrangement. Yeah. You leave the missus
behind.
The
wife.
Yeah. Look, house swapping. If you've got a, you know, great house that, you know, is also people want to, but you can actually just do house sitting as well. So you're not actually swapping your house, and this is great for the elder, for the older traveller as well, because.
But if you were somebody who was saying, I want somebody to come sit in my house, me, I would think I would choose the older person who's probably a bit more gentle and settled down. Not going to have a
That's right. Yeah, absolutely. So it's perfect for the older traveller. Put yourselves out on those house sitting sites, and, you know, because hotel costs can be, you know, biggest part of your bill when you're away, so you can get that down to next to zero.
Wow.
How fab. Phil Sylvester, you always have the best travel tips. Thank you.